Yeah. Hi everyone.
So last class we discussed about voltage control methods. Shunt compensation. Shunt compensation means shunt capacitors, shunt inductors, series capacitors, series inductors. We discussed there are static devices. And next is synchronous condenser, synchronous phase modifier, and synchronous coil we discussed. Now another one or two problems we'll solve here. So come to problem number one here in problem number one, a three phase induction motor runs 1000 kilovolt ampere. Means a three phase induction motor is connected to a transmission line induction motor is connected and it is drawing 1000 kilovolt ampere at a power factor of 0.8 at a power factor of 0.8 lag. Stop. A synchronous motor is connected in parallel to the same synchronous motor is connected in parallel. A synchronous motor is connected in parallel to draw an additional in that whatever is setting some additional extra 750 kVA at a power factor of 0.6 lead. It is taking the additional power. Then the examiner asking determine the power factor of the total load supplied by the main. Means how much amount of total power main is supplying. So the rating is given in kVA, nothing but what is the apparent power. So say I am going to assume this is supply apparent power and this is induction motor apparent power and the apparent power of synchronous motor. If I ask you the total, SS is equal to induction motor plus synchronous motor apparent power. What is induction motor apparent power is given? Induction motor apparent power is equal to 1000 at a power factor of 0.8 lag. Means if you return cos inverse of 0.8. So what you can get here? 1000 at an angle 36.18 degrees. Kilovolt and the apparent power in whole of 1000. Next, if we calculate synchronous motor, apparent power is equal to here our given 750 is taking at a power factor of minus cos inverse of 0.6 because it is lead. So, it has a mathematical calculation. Lead. So, what I can get here? 750 angle minus 53.416 degrees kVA kilovolt amperes. These are the powers apparent powers taken by the two loads, induction motor and the synchronous motor. Now example asking the total load supplied is solution here. Next problem we think the total load supplied by the source at load set is equal to apparent power of induction motor plus apparent power of synchronous motor, which is equal to 1000 at an angle 36.16 plus 750 at an angle minus 53.16 degrees -53.16 degrees. Now, if we calculate what we can get here, if you simplify by converting, if you add those two by converting polar form into rectangular, you can get the value as 1250 at an angle 0 degrees. Kilovolt amperes. Total load supplied by the source is 1250 at an angle 0 degrees. What example asking here? Determine the power factor of the total load. So power then here angle is nothing but what? Cos phi is nothing but what? Here 0. So 0. So cos 0 is nothing but what? 1 means the load is sending at the UPF of unity power factor. So the answer is load is sending at the unity power factor. 0 degrees means unity. The procedure to solve this type of problems. Next, come to next problem here. is given?
A.
275 kilovolts transmission line has the following wiring connections. 275 kilovolts transmission line is having the voltage rating of 275. 275 kV line has the following wiring connections. Line connections A, B, C parameter. Only A, B given. A parameter A given. Parameter B, B given. The transmission line is loaded by, this transmission line is loaded by 150 megawatts, a power factor of unity, and a power factor of unity. So the voltage profile at each end is maintained at 270, means here also you are going to use a different load by placing shunt compensation and receiving shunt compensation parallel. Compensation we are going to place in there. What is the purpose of this compensation? To maintain sending end voltage equal to receiving end voltage at receiving end. Then find the rating of this compensation required. Actually, what type of load is connected here? Here we connected, the load connected is resistive load into power factor. If it is resistive load, and inductive loads, if load increases, load voltage decreases. Load voltage decreases. Already discussed. In case of capacitive load, voltage increases. Receiving end voltage is greater than the sending end voltage. But load here is resistive, means receiving end voltage definitely less than 275 kilovolts. But to maintain both equal, shunt compensator is connected. Compensator is connected. Now the example is asking to increase the voltage level, what compensation we are going to use? We discussed already. Shunt capacitor we have to use. Here the compensator is connected and the exam asking what is the value of the compensation capacitor value per phase. What is the value of compensation value per phase? So we have to calculate first reactive power of shunt compensator. Shunt capacitor. How you can calculate? V per phase square divided by XC is equal to V square into 2 pi F C. Here, what values we know? Voltage values we know here. Frequency is given. Frequency is not given means as 50 Hz frequency. If frequency is not given means 50 Hz frequency. Capacitance value also not given. So capacitance value we have to calculate here, and the reactive power also we have to calculate. The reactive power is reactive power at receiving end side also we have to calculate. Two are the unknowns. So in these two we have to calculate one. So let us take the reactive power. So let us take the expression of reactive power. How we can calculate the expression? Reactive power is equal to Vs into Vr by mod B into sine beta minus delta minus mod A by mod B into Vr square into sine beta minus alpha. So formula. Now in this formula, you think about this formula here. With this formula, what you can get here? We'll get delta Q. So reactive power is unknown. Reactive power is unknown. Delta is also unknown. Because B is given how much? B is given 200 at angle 75. Beta. So beta is given. Alpha also given. Alpha is given as A at angle alpha 5 degrees. So here the unknown terms are, this is one unknown term and this is one unknown. So with these two unknown terms, it is not possible to calculate. Load rating is given as 150 megawatts. Means if you take a real power is given there. So if you take a real power expression, from this real power expression, we will get delta value. From this real power expression, we will get delta value. If you subtract the delta value, we can get reactive power expression. So assume this as equation 1. Now the reactive power, real power transformed to the load at receiving side is equal to expression we discussed already, mod Vs mod Vr by B into sine beta minus alpha minus mod A by mod B r square into sine, not sine cos, real over cos, 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 beta minus alpha. Substitute all the values here. If substitute all the values, this is given how much? 275. We are also 275. So you substitute it, and get expression as 275. 275 kilo. This also 275 kilovolts divided by V is given as 200. V is given there. V into cos. Beta is how much is given? Beta is equal to 75 minus delta is not given from this expression. We have to calculate delta value minus A given as 0.85 divided by 200 into 275 k whole square into cos. Beta is given how much? Beta 75 minus 5. 75 minus 5. Beta is alpha given as 5 degrees. Alpha is what? Mod A and negative power 4. Mod A and negative power 4. If you simplify this expression, you will get the expression for Vr. So if you simplify this, you can get expression like with the value of Vr. How much you can get value of Vr? If you substitute it, you can get Vr. So Vr value is given already. So Vr is given how much? Vr is 150. 150 megawatts. In this expression, you can get delta value. So if you simplify this expression, you can get delta value. The delta value will get as 28.42 degrees. Next, if you substitute this delta value in equation 1, by substituting delta in equation 1, we will get reactive power. So how much reactive power will get if you substitute this delta value 28.42 here in equation 1, we will get the magnitude of QR as minus 27.56. QR is equal to minus 27.56 mega volt ampere reactive rate. Mega volt ampere reactive rate. Because it is a reactive power. Next, combination here. Given load is what type of load? Given load. Q load is equal to what type of load is given? Is it pure resistive load? Means pure resistive load. Angle phase angle is equal to what? 0. So sine of 0 is nothing but 0. So real power taken by the load is 0. But you are sending reactive power from the source. Is receiving end. Plus compensation reactive power is equal to 2 load. Here load is not taking. Source is sending reactive power. And the compensator already provided to send reactive power. So compensator is sending reactive power, source is sending reactive power. The sum of those two reactive powers is equal to load reactive power. But load reactive power is given how much? 0. So from this one I can say QR is equal to minus QC. What we require? Compensator reactive power is required. So compensator reactive power is nothing but what here? Compensator reactive power is minus QR. So QR is how much? 7.56 mega volt ampere reactive. This we calculated for what? We take any given voltage to 75 means nothing but what? It is a line to line voltage. So line to line voltage means we are getting the power is 3 phase power. Here we have 3 phase reactive power. But capacitance we have to calculate per phase value. That's why if the QC reactive power composition per phase is equal to how much? 27.56 megavolt ampere reactive divided by T, which is equal to 9.17 megavolt ampere reactive. 9.17 megavolt ampere. one to the next. So they are called calculated. The rating we have calculated in the second problem, we have to calculate in the second determinant is we have to calculate the capacitance. Given is one connection, star connection. The star connection. Star connection. So the phase value is what here? 275 kilovolts by root 3. 275 kilovolts by root 3. Why? Because we have the previous time over the formula here. In this formula, we have to substitute all the values. See, here is the calculator. Here is not how much we see here 9.17 megavolt and the reactance is equal to V square is how much? 275 K by root 3. 4 square into 2 pi into 50 into capacitance value we have to calculate. Capacitance value here we have to calculate. So simplify, substitute this capacitance value here to get the value of capacitance. Substitute all the values to get capacitance. And get capacitance value as 1.16 microfarads. 1.16 microfarads. The problem here given is a 275 kilovolt line given three phase three transmission line and the following functions are given. Constants are just defined per phase. Given per phase, the transmission line is loaded with 150 megawatts with UPF load. Then the voltage profile at each end is maintained 275 kilovolts, means both sides you have to maintain 275 kilovolts. For that, the shunt compensator is placed at the receiving end. Then the exam asking what the rating of the shunt compensation, and in next asking the value of compensating capacitor if capacitor bank is star connected given. First we have to calculate rating of shunt compensation, set capacitor rating how we can define set capacitor V square per phase by X C per phase if you want it per phase. So this part I can write as reactive power shunt compensator is equal to V square into 2 pi of C. So here these two are the unknown terms are not given. So that's why we have to calculate first Q R. That's why I wrote here expression for Q R. If I after writing here Q R is unknown, delta unknown. That's why this expression is not sufficient to calculate Q R. That's why I'm going to take the real power expression. So real power value is given there as how much 150 megawatts. So real power supplied by root is equal to load received by load is equal to this formula RVS mu by beta B into cos beta minus delta minus A by D VR square cos beta minus alpha. And here in this formula, delta is only the unknown terms. Remaining all are given. A value given, B value given, beta given, beta 75, alpha given as 5 degrees in the problem. Given delta. So if substituted, you can get delta magnitude. Delta angle, delta value. So if you substitute delta value in reactive power expression, you can get the magnitude of reactive power supplied, reactive power received at the receiving end side. Now in the problem, examiner is asking that load is pure resistive load. For pure resistive load, power factor is unity, means phase angle is 0 degrees. If phase angle is 0 degrees, means reactive power is 0. Well, because the reactive power we are depending in terms of sin, VI sin phi, VI sin phi, real power VI cos theta like that. So, reactive power taken by total load is 0, but load is receiving supply reactive power, compensator reactive power. So, compensator supply reactive power is equal to 0. So, QR is equal to minus QC. QR already calculated, QC is equal to minus or minus 275, minus or minus 27.56. megavolt ampere reactive. So then you can get per phase value by dividing with 3. So with that you got reactive power per phase value. Substitute this value in this expression, you will get the magnitude of shunt capacitor. The given connection is star. That's why the voltage, line voltage is given as 275. 275 K by 3 is nothing but phase voltage magnitude. Like this, you also have this type of problems. So, previous exam model problem is this. So, practice more number of times to boost your knowledge of these concepts. The next compensator device is tap changing transformer. The next compensating device is tap changing transformer.
and changing transformer.
We are going to discuss about voltage control methods receiving end side. So this this also one method. This also comes under dynamic devices concept. Well, because here transformer also is a static device, but we are control the voltage. We are going to use one single phase induction motor on it. And that too, this method is used on power transformers only. Power transformers. For what type of transformers you can call power transformer? If any transformer is having power rating is more than 1 megavolt ampere. Or the voltage rating is more than 33 kV. The type of transformer is called power transformer. Below rating is called distribution transformer. Remember, means this tap changing method we are going to be using only on power transformer. Should we take a symbol for transformer, primary transformer, second. Generally remember, so supply voltage, supply current inputs. So between these two, magnetic core is there. So separate electric, because these are multiple isolated to represent the magnetic core, we are going to represent parallel lines. Remember, tap changers are always connected at high voltage rating side of your transformer. Why? Because if voltage levels are increasing, current levels decreases. If voltage levels increase, because transformer transfers constant power. Primary side power is equal to secondary side power. So that power rating, apparent power, that will depend on V high. So this side V is equal to this side V. If voltage increasing here, means current has to decrease to maintain apparent power as a constant. To maintain power as a KV rating of transformer is constant. That's why tap changers are placed at high voltage winding side. The advantage is, if tap changer means if any changes are happening, if current rating is low, means sparking doesn't exist because of high current, high square loss more. And if any changes, external changes current doesn't allow. So because of the sparking will exist. To overcome that, tap changers are placed always at high voltage winding side. So assume here one tap changer is connected. So single phase induction motor. It is always connected online. Because voltage control should do online. So tap changers are placed at the high voltage winding side. That's the point also. Tap changers are placed at high voltage winding side of power transformer. Always connected to the high voltage winding side of power transformer. And with this also, with the tap changers also, it is not possible to change the voltage automatically online. So in that case, again, our previous compensated method. It is not possible to control voltage and not possible to control armature. That's why again, our previous compensator, voltage compensators. Stators are connected at load side. Why? Because transformer it is not sufficient to send the required amount of voltage to the loads. So that time again these compensators are used. So what is the advantage of this is the compensator rating it will decrease here by using your tap changing transformers. Okay. That is depends on the budget. The rating of compensators it will reduce. With that, the advantage is cost of compensating device decreases. Cost of compensating device decreases. The advantage of this tap changer is the cost of compensating device decreases. Now here, the increment of voltage will be controlled by increasing the number of turns or decreasing the number of turns. So we know that if increase the number of turns, எப்படி நம்ம ட்ரான்ஸ்ஃபர் இங்கிலீஷ் மீன்ஸ் ஃப்ளக்ஸ் கட்டிங் த கோர் இஸ் மோர் ஃப்ளக்ஸ் கட்டிங் த கோர் இஸ் மோர் மீன்ஸ் இன்டியூஸ் EMF வோல்டேஜ் will get increases you know already இன்டியூஸ் EMF is directly proportional to what is the transformer the இன்டியூஸ் EMF is directly proportional to rate of change of ஃப்ளக்ஸ் லிங்கேஜஸ் வித் n கான்ஸ்டன்ட் also if number of turns increases also the இன்டியூஸ் EMF angle will get increases so like this we use a tap changer transformer also in voltage control applications so these are about voltage control and power factor improvement techniques so how many methods we use here the number of methods we use here are 8 methods the first one is shunt capacitor I'm going to give you conclusion on the shunt capacitor second one is shunt inductor and inductor or shunt reactor we can call third one is what series capacitor fourth one is synchronous coil fifth one is synchronous condenser sixth one is synchronous phase modifier or advancer and the seventh one is series inductor and the eighth one is tap changing transformer eighth one is tap changing transformer and for what purpose do you use the shunt capacitor here the purpose of shunt capacitor everyone we are using what control the voltage means to increase the receiving end voltage or to decrease the receiving end voltage depends on the type of load connected. The purpose of shunt capacitor, even though we are going to be using it for increasing the voltage levels, but the practical purpose of the shunt capacitor, what is studied? To improve power factor improvement purpose. Power factor improvement purpose, we are going to be using shunt capacitor. Next, what is the purpose of shunt inductor? The purpose of shunt inductor, what you studied? The purpose of shunt inductor is to reduce Ferranti effect. You know what is Ferranti effect? Receiving end voltage is more than sending end. That condition is called Ferranti effect condition. The next capacitor device is series capacitor. What is the purpose of series capacitor? Even though if you connect the capacitor in series the load, here this is the purpose of series capacitor. Here is to maintain stability means even though if you can see a capacitor in series with the line, the voltage of the line decreases. Due to that, the load voltage, receiving end voltage increases, but compared to the voltage, that is called voltage stability. Here, the load, because of increment of maximum power transfer, the delta we are going to decrease. It means angular stability we are going to increase. Angular delta decreases means angular stability increases. So, compared to voltage stability, angular stability plays a major role in power systems. That's why. Series capacitor is to maintain stability, means to increase the stability. To increase the stability. And next is synchronous coil. What is the purpose of this synchronous coil? The purpose of synchronous coil is same like series inductor, shunt inductor, to reduce Ferranti effect. We are going to use synchronous coil. And what I showed about this shunt condenser, the purpose of shunt condenser is same as like shunt capacitor. To improve power factor. A synchronous phase modifier or advancer. What is the purpose of the synchronous phase modifier or advancer? Depends on the load type of load connected. This also we are using for power factor improvement. And what is the purpose of series conductor here? To limit fault current. The purpose of auto transformer is to change voltage levels. Maybe to increase the receiving end voltage depends on requirement to reduce the receiving end voltage. It will be done by one automatic single phase induction motor. These are about voltage control methods. conversation. Thank you very much.